Bobby Miller was a middle child in a family with six kids. She had four sisters and one brother. Her eldest sister says being a mother to Bobby's two children was her unwavering priority. This family is desperate for the killer to be caught.
I was listening to Channel 9 and I was getting ready for work, and I heard that a 54-year-old woman in Gilford was murdered. And as soon as I heard that, I thought of Bobby.
Nearly 2 months to the day that 54-year-old Bobby Miller was murdered inside her newly purchased Gilford home, Donna Holden says the family is desperate for an arrest, fearful that this case may be lost in the shuffle. Donna is anxious to know what kind of evidence was pulled from the crime scene.
It's keeping you awake at night.
I think it's the fingerprints, but I don't know. Is there something in forensics that could be changed? Do they not have enough staff? Do we have antiquated equipment? And maybe what they do is fine, and maybe this is how long it takes.
Bobby's two kids were everything to her, according to Donna. Her son lived right around the corner and was the one who discovered her body on November 1st.
I do know how many gunshots there were. There was one to the dog and two to my sister. One was in the back of her head, so I assume she was running.
Donna speaks with the victim's advocate from the AG's office weekly, but says her calls to Assistant Attorney General Ben Agati have gone unreturned. And while she appreciates their efforts, she is getting discouraged.
Last week, I was told it could take several months.
Bobby Miller was still embroiled in an emotional and financially messy divorce from her husband, Gary, and had just purchased this Gilford home, her family says, using her share of the proceeds from the sale of their vacation property in Maine. But Donna says the turmoil is not how Bobby will be remembered.
I know there's a lot of people out there that think the world of my sister, and I guess I just want her to be remembered for what she was.
News 9 reached out to the Attorney General's office, the Major Crimes Unit, and the State Forensics Lab for a progress report on this case. None was available. Live in the studio, Amy Covino, WMUR News 9.